The press under siege, or so they claim, following the Securities and Exchange Commission's order against news website Rappler. Now comes a proposal to amend the Bill of Rights, seeking to limit the state guarantee on free press. The proposal at the House Subcommittee wants this to apply only to the responsible exercise of the freedom of speech, expression, and of the press. But who would now determine if a report is responsible or not? Former Solicitor General Florine Hilbay warned the amendment could be used to stifle the press, using irresponsible reporting as an excuse.
The danger in inserting the word responsible is that you're giving the state the power to define responsibility.
House Deputy Speaker Fred Castro earlier defended the proposed amendment. But on ANC's early edition on Thursday, he raised his own questions as well.
The same is my idea. No? I join you there, Florine. Okay, who is the one who will be responsible in defining the term responsible? If you are going to place it there, it simply becomes more blatant that the state will have to rely on this in trying to curtail exercise.
No, so you're not supporting it.
Castro also clarified the proposal didn't come from his subcommittee, which is now looking into proposed amendments to the Constitution.
It came from an extrinsic source.
Who is?
The Presidential Committee on Human Rights Secretariat.
The Presidential Human Rights Committee Secretariat is under the office of the President. But Presidential Spokesperson Harry Roque clarified President Duterte could not be tied to the Secretariat's proposal. Speaking with ABS-CBN News, an official of the Human Rights Secretariat confirmed the proposal had indeed come from its office. He said the Secretariat submitted the proposal only because it had been asked by the House Subcommittee late last year. He said it's not meant to curtail press freedom, but only to emphasize the need for more self-regulation within the ranks of the news media. Christian Esguerra, ABS-CBN News.